So after hours and hours of sanding and priming and sanding and filling and sanding and priming and sanding and filling and sanding and priming some more, and finally saying, that's it, man, screw it. It is what it is. It looks pretty damn good. What do you think, Don?
I think it does look pretty good. Yep. I think we've put, we've literally, besides the two coats of primer that got rolled on with a paint roller, and then got sanded off, we have also mixed up 4 pounds of two-part primer, and on two different occasions, shot 2 pounds of it on here, and Frank then dutifully sanded most of it off, and started looking pretty good, and when we put the panel tapes on here, we shot another 2 pounds of primer.
And sanded it off again.
Sanded enough to get the orange peel off. Mm. And what we've got now is, well, it's as good as it's going to get.
A big gray,
pretty darn good.
Yeah, a big gray canoe getting ready to turn silver,
yeah.
Which will be the base coat. And then we'll throw some grease on it. And then shoot the other colors and then wipe the grease off, and that will automatically give us the beginnings of our weathered look, kind of, more or less.
For those who aren't familiar, this is a de-waxer, de-greaser.
Right.
Just to remove any skin oils, because Frank is Italian.
Hey, careful.
So you know he's oily.
Is that where the term came from? Greasy Italian?
It's all that good olive oil.
Yeah, good olive. Yes, that's it, man. Nothing but the best. Extra virgin. I don't know if you can see this very clearly, but this is the bottom of the wing, center section for that B24. It's all in dove gray. Top will be green. OD green. Inside the flap sections are zinc chromate, of course. Down there are the wing panels, the outer panels. This is 12-foot wing, Don Smith airplane. And we're getting close. Anyway, we shot the silver on the top side. And on the wing cover, center section. Looks nice. And in about a minute now, we will turn it over.
Well, we're going to do it right now.
We're going to do it right now. Here we go. Okay, so the idea now is to carefully flip it over, lay it on those calibrated thinner cans, and shoot the bottom. Okay? And we'll be back. Okay. So since it's more stable, I decided I'll just go ahead and film. Besides that, it's hard to drink a beer when you're wearing a paint mask. I think I'll just get upwind of the paint, which is probably a good idea. Because, not that I don't trust him with a spray gun, but he can get a little bit weird. This is KlassKote that we're shooting, by the way. And after almost completing the airplane, I think Don's finally figured out the correct mixture so that it flows on, that the next coat looks like the first coat. You don't have that mottled look.
Yeah, this is turning out okay.
It's turning out okay. And like we said, after this is dry, we'll use a technique to cover areas that we don't want olive drab or gray on, and that will become the wear marks and chip marks of a warbird signature, so to speak.
Okay, we'll let that sit for about 5 minutes, and then we'll put one more light coat on and it'll be done.
Cool. We'll be okay. So this is coat number two going on. Only about 5 or 6 minutes have passed. Stuff dries rapidly. Lays out nice. Also smells really great.
on that.
Mmm, love it.
Yeah, if you like wrap.
Yeah, I'm going to put my mask back on here very shortly, I think.
That is?
That's it. Okay, how about the top?
Top.
Done? Okay. Man says we're done, we're done. That's enough silver. See you later. Okay, go ahead and go into action. Okay, we just got through shooting the gray. If we sound funny, it's because we're talking through a mask. But all the splotches on there are grease, which after they're cleaned off will simulate chipmunks. That's coming along pretty cool. The green is really going to make this thing pop. Really going to make it pop. So hopefully tomorrow we start shooting OD green on the rest of the airplane and getting down to the short stores now. Cool. I think we're good. What do you think?
Let's give it about 5-10 minutes to flash off and see if we've got full coverage.
Okay.
I think we're good, but
okay.
We got a little bit of paint left.
Okay. Okay. You can clearly see the full weathering that we're getting ready to do, the chipmunks and paint, stuff like that.
Yeah, for the Bombay doors.
For the Bombay doors and the such.
Okay.
We'll be back. Okay, so here we are, 24 hours approximately later. And the gray has been put on the top. I beg your pardon, the bottom. And all the grease spots. The center section of the wing has been mounted, and we're going to try to shoot some green today. Anyway, give you an idea what this beast looks like. And say hello, Don.
Hey, Don, how you doing, man?
Yeah, right.
All the cool guys are called Don.
Don, right. All the Italian bosses are called Don, so it must be okay. Anyway, here we are. And we'll eventually get all this out for all you guys to see if you're interested. Okay, so now here we are, 12 feet later.
Not that it matters one little bit.
Right.
But.
I know.
I've always.
Not any, I know. Let's see if we got as close as we did on the B-29.
I've always been interested
in just how far we are out.
Yeah.
Okay, we'll be back. Well, we just took a measurement. And once the wings are seated, we're an eighth of an inch out of square. Maybe we ought to try and build it again, huh? Okay, see ya. Here's Don taking a picture of me, taking a picture of Don with an airplane in the way. Looking pretty good. Here we are. So here we are, we've shot the olive drab and it's looking really good. There's a fuselage. We're about to make a little finer demarcation line between the gray and the green. And that will basically be the end of the color on this. And then remove all the grease and have the silver show through. It'll look pretty cool. Nice and weathered. Okay, we're going to go over and show you the wings.
the outer wing panels anyway, and the horizontal stabilizing rudders. We'll be back.
See ya.
Here's some of the other bits and pieces. The horizontal stabilizers, the rudders, the outer wing panels.